Hello everybody and welcome to my tutorial on how to make a texture pack for Minecraft. Now first thing we're going to need are two pieces of software. If you've already got your own software, skip to about the time when I'm actually making it. I use GIMP. GIMP is a image editing tool that is vastly superior to Microsoft Paint. Never use that for a texture pack, and it's also free but has the usability of paint.net or PaintShop Pro or Photoshop. This is free, so if you want it, just download it. It'll work on Windows 7 64-bit, so if you've got a 32-bit operating system, it'll work easily. The other piece of software we're going to be using is either WinRAR or 7-zip. Both are free, so you need them to pack them both into a zip file, so you can use WinRAR for that or 7-zip, it's up to you. So whichever one you want to use them. I'll put the links in the description, and now we better get started. Right, the first thing we're going to do is make a folder, so wherever you want to put it, just make a folder. I'll call it Gobble Pack. No idea why, but I'm just going to call it that. There we go. This is where we're going to make and put our textures. Now, we're going to have to get the default textures of Minecraft and work our way up from there. So just find your way to the Minecraft folder. If you don't know where it is, look on another video, because you should know where that is by now if you play Minecraft. So yeah, we'll just enter into bin, find our Minecraft jar. Ooh, I think I've already updated mine, so I better find the original. There it is. Alright, just go to your Minecraft jar. If you haven't put a texture pack in it already, just go to normalminecraft.jar and open with WinRAR or 7-zip. I don't think 7-zip opens it up. I have no clue, but I use WinRAR, so for this tutorial I'll be showing just WinRAR. Okay, so here it is. Here are all the files for Minecraft. Now what you're going to need for any basic texture pack, all you're going to need really is the terrain.png. That is the main one. That is where all the changes happen. Let's double click that and just have a look at it. See? That is where most the default texture packs will be made. So we'll just work on that now. And then I'll let you sort the others. You just search around and you'll find other textures for other things. Like miscellaneous, you've got foliage, pumpkin, water, etc. items. Yep, so you just rubble through that, find the ones you want to change, and you can change that. Now we're going to change terrain, so just right click that, edit with GIMP. Now GIMP has this little feature where you can use a grid, or other editing software have that also, but I'm not going to show you how to do that on them. I'm just going to show you how to do it on GIMP because I'm a little freebie. Just wait for this to open. It might take a while because I haven't used it in so long. Here we go. Wakey wakey. Okay. Now somebody zoom in. Right. So what we're going to do first is we're going to make a grid so we don't mess around. We know exactly where to do it. You can see where all the squares are, but sometimes you can't make the lines out when you're in a little rush. So yeah, you just want to click on Image, Configure Grid. It'll bring up this, and the spacing, you'll want to change that. This is the default Minecraft is 16 by 16. We're going to be making... Well, we're not going to be making, I'm just going to be showing you how you can make different texture packs. So if you're making a higher res texture pack, say 32 by 32, 64 by 64, you'll want to put in the spacing of that. So if you're making a 16 by 16, or 16 by 16, 32 by 32, so yeah, I'm just going to show you a 32 by 32 for now. Okay, spacing there. You'll want to click on View, Show Grid, and Snap to Grid. As you can see, faint lines there. That's 32 by 32, but the pack itself isn't actually 32 by 32, so we'll have to scale that. Where's scale? There we go. Image, scale, image. We'll want to change that from 256 to 512. There we go. Boom. And you see it's gone a little more blurry because that's what happens when you put it up. But yeah, we're going to be making a different texture pack, so this is just going to be used as a template to tell you what it is. You want to create a new layer, and we'll do a new dirt texture. Simple, really. Okay, right, now what we're going to do is, yep, we want to make sure it's on show grid, snap to grid, because that means if it snaps to grid, it will go, as you can see from that, it'll just snap straight to there. So you just highlight that so you don't go over the edges, and now you can draw to your heart's content. Now I'm just going to make a just a quick texture, really. Find the best brown. There you go, default brown texture. You just mess around with it. You draw what you like. You know, you can copy and paste images to it, but you know, it's just it's. You know, you won't be a very good texture artist if you just do that. You can use them as references. I'll never condone that. But yeah, you just draw what you like. I'm just rushing. I'm not being thorough with this. Let's make a different texture. So this is essentially, you keep doing this for all the boxes. If you want to leave them the way they are, they will. They won't look much different in game, but you know, as you made them higher res, it'll be slightly more noticeable. It'll be slightly more blurred. So yeah, if you look at it like that, it'd be slightly blurry, so it won't look as good. So yeah, it's best to go over all the textures the best way you can, really. Just keep going over them. I'm just rushing this. I'm not going to pay much attention to it because I'm never going to use this ever. So I'll just blend that all in. Yeah, it's got a nice little muddy patch in the middle of it. Okay. There we go. It's got a lot. It's crap essentially. But yeah, that's that. And then when you've done that, just copy, paste that into there. And you'll just want to, yeah, just rush it. There we go. Completely rushed. That's how you do it. Make sure you stay within all these squares. All these squares are right. Whatever stays in there will be on that specific block. If you carry on the iron ore, say, stretch it to over there, it'll overlap onto that. That's why on some texture packs, mine, on wool, for example, I've rushed them, I weren't really rushed. And when I resized them, sometimes they stuck over the edge, like, say, that. Oh, nah, I cocked up, but then I, hold on. So yeah, when I resized it down, I configured it to the grid, but sometimes the grid is off by like a tiny pixel, but that pixel is really noticeable. You see where that line is? Sometimes it'll stick over by one pixel, and it's just, you know, that's what happens sometimes. And as you can see, when I resized it up, it's gone over, the red has actually already gone over, pink has gone over to the grey one, green. They've blended into each other. You can see how it's a nightmare. But for me, I make my texture packs 512 by 512. That Minecraft will never be able to run that, but I make them as high res as possible, then resize them down so it does so it loses hardly any resolution in that at all. So yeah, that's what I do. Ooh. But yeah, that's how you do it. Then when you've done that, you'll just want to merge the layers, and you'll want to save that as. Go to where it is, desktop, gobble pack, terrain.png, save that, replace, yeah, rush job, simples, close that down, and then when you've done with that, you'll want to add to archive if you're using WinRAR. Now with 7-Zip, I think there's an option on here for you to add to archive, and that, I have no idea, so I'll do gobble pack 01, and you don't want it to be a RAW, because if it's a 16x16, I think RAW will be fine in the normal Minecraft texture menu. But for MC Patcher, RAW has been removed as of the latest update on Saturday, I think it might have been. So you'll want to change that to a zip. Once that's all packed up, it's all ready for MC Patcher, and you're ready to move on to my tutorial that I made before this that shows you how to use MC Patcher to patch your Minecraft with a texture pack, namely higher res ones. So yeah, that's how you would do that. If you need any more help, post your comments, send me messages, find me anywhere, send me an email, whatever, and I'll get back to you. And I'll see you guys later.